This is the Great Seal from the dollar bill, and it's very important, this symbolism. This is the separated capstone, and what that represents is the knowledge retained by the few. Now, these guys absolutely believe that they are the rightful rulers of a global fiefdom, and that humanity is effectively their slaves. And unfortunately, in many cases, you know, our behaviour perhaps just goes to endorse that view, because a lot of this occurs basically because we let it. Now, just bear with me for a few minutes, because I want to introduce you to some text that comes from a document that was actually published in 1967, but it's from a right-wing think tank, an extreme right-wing think tank, that met in the early 60s, just at the start of the real Cold War. And it's called the Report from Iron Mountain. It's been dismissed as a forgery, but let me tell you that Zbigniew Brzezinski, who is the guy who, by the way, has effectively mentored and nurtured Obama for the last 27 years. It's no accident that he becomes president at this time. Anybody who still thinks that he walks on water is about to get a very rude awakening. But in this document, it said, wars are not caused by international conflicts of interest. Proper logical sequence would make it more often accurate to say that war-making societies require and thus bring about such conflicts. It's exactly what was occurring here. I mean, you actually have to suspend your belief in Newtonian physics to actually swallow the official version of what occurred here. But I'm not going to dwell too much on 9/11 tonight, because I don't think there's probably too many people in the room who still believe the official version. So in this report from Iron Mountain, it says, war is a general social release. This is a psychosocial function serving the same purpose for society as do the holiday, the celebration, and the orgy for the individual. I mean, just ponder on that. So basically what they're saying is they can either lay on wars or they can lay on orgies. I guess, you know, either way you get fucked, right? You saw in the film, Gordon Brown, that was actually a recording of a speech he gave at the Confederation of British Industry on the 15th of May 2007. And that was just a short extract, but he mentioned the phrase New World Order, I think a total of 9 times in that speech. Now, the phrase New World Order had never crossed Gordon Brown's lips until January of that year, 2007. Now, this is obviously 6 months or so before he was basically just shooed in into the Prime Minister's office. Now, I said in 2006 that this guy would never be elected as Prime Minister. I stand by that. But I was wrong in 2006, because I said that I felt that this guy actually had some moral backbone, and the reason that he would never become elected as Prime Minister was because he would not tolerate the bullshit that he would be expected to front in the role of Prime Minister. How wrong I was. He has sold his soul. He is so desperate to remain in number 10 that he will basically do anything that he's told, including collapse the British economy. But he ain't going to win the next election, that's for sure, because Princess Dave is being groomed for that role.
Yeah, this one's pretty strange, isn't it?
Y'all. I'm not afraid to die.